My name's Devin, and this is my last lecture. Chapter 3, Hooper. Ever since I was a child, I knew I was going to be an athlete. At an early age, I was constantly involved in many sports, such as swimming, soccer, football, and types of stuff like that. But I knew my passion for basketball and the love of the game was above any other. Everything it has done and does for me has helped me become the hooper and man I am today. The moment of lacing up my shoes and stepping on the court just gives me a whole new attitude and feeling. It becomes an art for me. It becomes more than a game, but a lifestyle. Being on the hardwood and playing games just helps me enter a new place and forget about everything in my life that's distracting me. I blow out all the noise and just take out the distractions of my life and just focus on the sound of the game. Basketball has played a very important role in my life, and I couldn't imagine a life without it. Chapter 2, Parent Lottery. I am so thankful for my parents that they have done so much for me and sacrificed a lot as well. I love them both and couldn't be more thankful for them. My dad is often seen as a mean and unfriendly man because he always has his shades on, never smiles or talks. It's also because he has many tattoos on his arm from his old gangs as he grew up in Watts and South Central LA. He is mean, but over time you get to know him and he's not that bad. My mom is the opposite though. She has a large smile, is very friendly, and talks a lot. She does so much for me and is a huge role model in my life. I could not imagine the man I would be without her. Chapter 4, My Pops. I never grew up with much family. I didn't like my father and didn't like me as I was his son. Much of my family was his friends and homies that he grew up with. During my life, I never looked up to anyone or had someone to, but now I can say that I do. He may not be the nicest person, and he's done a lot of bad things in his life, but he's always been able to guide me and teach me. From teaching me to ride bikes, dribble or throw football, fix and drive cars, put things together, and just to act like a man. He has always been real with me and gives it how it is. As I've gotten older, he has become more older, mentally maturing and never being soft with me. He has raised me to be ready for the harsh world and has helped me become a stronger individual. My work ethic and hunger for success comes from him as he instilled it at a young age. Without my pops, I wouldn't even know what hip hop was. He has been a father, mentor, and a huge role model in my life. Chapter 6, Putting in the Work. Growing up, I was never handed anything in life, and I had to earn it putting in the time, whether it was for academics, sports, or anything really. As a young child, I was stupid, barely learned how to write and read, and struggled a lot for this a while through my schooling, until I began to work and be better and change it. I was not born with a gift of being smart or academically prepared. This led me to spending extra time getting frustrated on learning how to read and write. I failed many challenges as well, such as my first sparring event and trying to dunk on Zane. I kept trying to dunk on him, but it never happened, but I wasn't willing to give up and was willing to put in the time and work to hit it again. Another big failure was when I was cut from my 15 AU team because I was not good enough. I never gave up and came back starting and stronger and was eventually bumped up to the 16 and 17 U. Chapter 7, Looking Back. One word to describe the past 16 years of my life and the end of my sophomore year is different. Life as a teenager can be very difficult because it's a transition between growing up from being a child and becoming an adult, either a young woman or a young man. As teenagers, we are supposed to be learning how to prepare for the world and be ready to move out from our parents' house. This is the title that is placed on us to be our future after we finish the stressing and rigorous 4 years of high school. But in reality, it does not work that way and is never that easy. Many distractions come into play, such as the culture or society. All I can say is to chase after what you want and not let anything get in your way. Don't listen to what the culture or society has to say. Be your own and secure your bag. Be happy with who you are and be appreciated for everything during the 4 years. Stay true to yourself and get the bag. Whether it may be success, academics, money, or whatever it is, just secure it. Don't follow the steps that everyone says you have to, no matter who it is. Be happy, be humble, be different. The heartbreaks, the stress, the fake friends, the bad teachers, and much more is to come. Let's be open to help, but never lose focus on what you want for your life and what you want in it. And remember, just to enjoy the 4 years of high school and always be appreciative of everything you have.
La 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 la.